Today we will discuss about MCQ for Engineering Graphics and Design, Part 7. So welcome to my YouTube channel, Mechanical Engineering Management. So in the last video, Part 1 to 6, we have discussed up to 60 questions. So let's start with the question number 61. The solid having a polygon for a base and triangular lateral faces intersecting at a vertex is option pyramid, prism, cone, cylinder. So we'll check one by one all these four options. So let's start with the option A, pyramid. So this is the square pyramid, and according to the description it is given to you, solid having a polygon for base. So here you can see the base is the polygon. Polygon, that means number of sides more than two, and triangular lateral faces. So here you can see triangular lateral face. So A is the correct answer, although we will check all these options. Now consider the B, prism. Here you can see the prism having top and bottom both are the polygon, but having rectangular lateral faces, and in our description it should be triangular lateral face. So B is not possible. Now consider the cone. So cone having no any lateral faces. In cylinder also no any lateral faces. Looking all these four options, pyramid having only the triangular lateral faces, and so that A is the correct answer. Next, the primary unit of measurement for engineering drawing and design in the mechanical industries is the option millimeter, centimeter, meter, kilometer. We have drawn so many drawings in the drawing sheets, and we have written always on the drawing sheet that all dimensions are in mm. So A is the right answer. Next, when a solid is placed such that axis is inclined with both the HP and VP, its projection are drawn in stages. Option 1, 2, 3, 4. In the description it is given to you, a solid is inclined to HP and VP both, then how many stages are required to get the projections? There are actually three stages. In first stage, the solid objects in simple position. Generally, either the axis is perpendicular to HP or perpendicular to VP. In second stage, axis is inclined to one plane. Say for example it is HP, then parallel to other plane, that means VP. In third stages, axis is inclined to remaining plane. That means we have considered in second stage, axis is inclined to HP. So now it is inclined to VP in third stage. In short, we can say in first stage, axis is perpendicular to HP or VP. In second stage, axis is inclined to one plane, and in third stage, axis is inclined to remaining plane. So here solid is inclined to both HP and VP. That means three stages required. So C is the right answer. I will show you one problem solution so that you can understand easily these three stages. So here you can see the pentagonal pyramid is inclined 30 degree to HP and 45 degree to VP, and so that in first stage axis is perpendicular to HP, in second stage it is inclined to HP, and in third stage it is inclined to VP. So three stages are required if it is inclined to HP and VP both. Now next, if a solid is cut by a cutting plane parallel to the base of the solid and top part is removed, the remaining part is called option frustum of a solid, truncated solid, oblique solid, part solid. So I am going to show you first of all the figure. So this is actually square pyramid, top part is removed. Whatever it may be the solid, if top part is removed, that means the part containing apex is removed, then the remaining portion is known as frustum of pyramid. If it is a cone, then it is called as frustum of cone. So in short, we can say if top part is removed, then it is called as the frustum of solid. Next, a right regular hexagonal prism is resting on HP on its base. Its top view is a option square, rectangle, hexagon, pentagon. So let's consider the figure. Reference plane HP and VP, and I have considered over here regular hexagonal prism that is resting on HP on its base. So this blue color is the base and this blue color is the top. Now as per the description, its top view is, so if I want to see the top view, then looking in the top direction. So in this direction if I see, then I will get the top view is like that. And now you can imagine this top view is also the hexagon. So C is the correct answer. Next, which of the following position is not possible for a right solid? Option: axis perpendicular to HP and parallel to VP, axis parallel to VP and perpendicular to PP, axis parallel to both VP and HP, axis perpendicular to both VP and HP. So first of all, consider the figure. So I have taken reference plane HP and VP, and I have considered one hexagonal prism that is resting on HP on its base, and axis is perpendicular to HP, and so that it is by default parallel to VP. So if axis is perpendicular to HP, then it is by default parallel to VP. So look at the option D, perpendicular to both VP and HP, and that is not possible anyhow. So according to our description, which option is not possible? So D is not possible. Next, the top view of a right cylinder resting on HP on its base rim is option ellipse, circle, rectangle, square. So consider the figure. Reference plane, I have considered the right cylinder resting on HP on its base, and if I want to see the top view, then you can understand the top view is also circle. So B is the right answer. Next, a tetrahedron has four equal blank faces. Options: square, rectangular, triangular, none of the above. So first of all, consider the figure of the tetrahedron. So this is the tetrahedron having four equal triangular faces, and so that C is the right answer. Next, the sectional plane are represented by option continuous thick line, continuous thin line, chain thin line, chain thin line having thick edges. So here you have to remember, for any sectional plane, it is always represented by chain thin line having thick edges. So D is the right answer. So I am going to show you one of the figures so that you can understand easily. So this is the reference line XY. This is a solid object and it is cut by the sectional plane. And you can see over here, this is the chain line having thick edges. So having thick edges for the sectional plane. Next, when the prism is placed vertically on one of its end faces, the end face on which the prism rests is called the blank, and the vertical side faces are the blank faces. Options: bottom, lateral, base, lateral, base, longitudinal, horizontal, lateral. So consider the figure. Here it is a solid and that is the prism, and as per the description, it is placed vertically on one of its end face. The end face on which the prism rests, so this is the end face on which the prism rests, that face is known as base. So first blank is the base. And second, the vertical side faces, these four vertical side faces. That is known as lateral face. So second option is lateral face. So base and lateral, so B is the right answer. So keep watching. We will continue the same session in the next video. So thanks, my dear friends.